1.1. What is the force between two small charged spheres having charges 2 × 10⁻⁷ coulomb and 3 × 10⁻⁷ coulomb placed 30 cm apart in air? Force between the charges is constant, Q1 Q2 by R square. This constant is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught equal to 9 × 10⁹ is the constant. Q1 Q2 2 × 10⁻⁷, Q2 is 3 × 10⁻⁷ by 0.3 meter, 3 × 10⁻¹ square. Simplification becomes easier, so I am writing in this format, 3 × 10⁻¹ meter square. Now this is 3 square, 9 get cancels, 3 to 6, 6 into 10⁻¹⁴, 9 minus 5, 10⁻¹⁵ by 10⁻², so it is 10⁻³ Newton. This is the force. Since these two are positive charges, there is a repulsion between the charges, so direction is away from each other. Repulsive in nature. Second problem. The electrostatic force on a small sphere of charge 0.4 microcoulomb due to another small sphere of charge minus 0.8 microcoulomb in air is 0.2 Newton. What is the distance between the two spheres? Is given 0.2 Newton. Distance is R. (9, 10⁻⁹, 0.4, 10⁻⁶, first charge, 0.8, 10⁻⁶, second charge, distance is R square, force is 0.2, 0.21, 0.2, 2, 9, 0.8 into 2 is 1.6, 10⁻⁶, since I want R, take this R square, remaining is 10⁻⁶, 10⁻⁶, this is 10⁻⁹. If we take square root, we can get square root for all this, but not for this. So give 10 to this, it becomes 9, 16, 10⁻⁶, 10⁻⁶, 10⁻⁸. This is R square, which is equal to R, 9, square root is 3, this is 4, this is 10⁻⁶, 10⁻⁴. So R equal to 12 into 10⁻². Which is 0.12 meter. What is the force on the second sphere due to the first? Force between these two spheres is 0.2 Newton. Then force on the second sphere due to first is also same. From Newton's third law of motion, the forces are action and reaction pair, and force on second sphere is 0.2 Newton towards each other, because one is positive charge, the other one is negative charge, so there is attraction. So this is the direction of force. check that the ratio k e square divided by g mass of electron mass of proton is dimensionless. Look up a table of physical constants and determine the value of this ratio. What does the ratio signify? K e square by g mass of electron mass of proton. This is given. Electrostatic force between two charges is K, charge of electron, charge of a proton by distance square, implies K e square is force into distance square. Force into distance square is Newton meter square. Similarly, gravitational force between two masses, capital G, mass of electron, mass of proton by distance square, implies G, mass of electron, mass of proton equal to FR square. Again, Newton meter square. Unit of K e square is Newton meter square. Unit of G ME MP is also Newton meter square. Newton is M L T minus 2. Meter square is L 2. This is the dimensional formula, divided by again M L T minus 2 L 2 equal to 0. M 0 L 0 T 0. Is dimensionless. Look up a table of physical constants and determine the value of this ratio. K e square by g mass of electron mass of proton equal to, constant is 9 10 power 9. This is constant in electrostatics, divided by gravitational constant is 6.67 10 power minus 11. Charge of electron 1.6 10 power minus 19. Charge of proton is also same, magnitudes square. Mass of electron is 9.1 10 power minus 31 kg. Mass of proton is approximately 1.67 10 power minus 27 kg. It turns out to be 0.227 10 power 40, or 2.27 10 power 39. This number signifies that the electrostatic force between an electron and a proton is 2.27 10 power 39 times stronger than the gravitational force between them. Fourth problem. Explain the meaning of the statement, electric charge of a body is quantized. A body acquires positive charge by losing electrons. A body acquires negative charge by gaining electrons. Therefore, Q equal to plus or minus N into E, where N is 1, 2, 3, etc. and magnitude of charge 1.6. 10 power minus 19 coulomb. Therefore, total charge of a body is an integral multiple of 1.6 10 power minus 19 coulomb. Either the body can lose n number of electrons or it can gain n number of electrons, but never the fractional values of this. That is why electric charge of a body is quantized. Why can one ignore quantization of electric charge when dealing with macroscopic, that is large scale charges? In macroscopic scale, the magnitude of charge is very large compared to charge of an electron. Hence, quantization of charge can be neglected. When a glass rod is rubbed with silk cloth, charges appear on both. A similar phenomenon is observed with many other pair of bodies. Explain how this observation is consistent with the law of conservation of charge. Consider two suitable material bodies A and B. Let this be A. This second body is B. Due to friction, if A loses few electrons to B, then electrons are transferred. Since electrons are removed from A, it acquires positive charge. And electrons are added to B, it acquires negative charge. Initially, both are electrically neutral. Due to friction, if the body A loses electrons to body B, then A acquires positive charge, that is plus N into A, where N is number of electrons, and B acquires negative charge, minus N into A. Total charge is plus N into A minus N into A equal to 0. This shows that total charge is conserved. Initially, both are electrically neutral. After friction, because of transfer of electrons also, total charge is low. Therefore, this shows that total charge is conserved. Four point charges, 2 micro, minus 5 micro, 2 micro, minus 5 micro, are located at the corners of a square ABCD of side 10 cm. What is the force on a charge of 1 microcoulomb placed at the center of the square? Look at the distribution of charge, symmetric distribution of charge about the point O. Minus 5, minus 5, equal charges. 2, 2, equal distances. Since the distribution of charges is symmetric, the resultant electric field at O is 0. Therefore, the resultant force on 1 microcoulomb at O is 0. Let us prove this mathematically. AC equal to root of AD square plus TC square equal to root of 10 square plus 10 square. It is 10 root 2 centimeter. Therefore, AO is half of AC. AC by 2. 10 root 2 by 2. 5 root 2 centimeter. Next, let us write the formula. We have to keep 1 microcoulomb at the center. Observe carefully. These two are positive charges. Therefore, there exists repulsion. There exists repulsion. But we have to mention force on 1 microcoulomb. Because of repulsion, this is the force on 1 microcoulomb due to charge at A. Similarly, because of 2 and 1, these two positive charges, there is repulsion. There is repulsion and force on 1 microcoulomb is away. So due to repulsion, this is the force. Force due to C. FC. Now, this 1 microcoulomb minus 5 microcoulomb plus minus, there exists attraction. Because of attraction, the force on 1 microcoulomb is towards B. Therefore, this is this force of attraction. So, this force is due to charge at B. Similarly, there exists attraction. Therefore, force on 1 microcoulomb is towards this. This is the force. Force on D. Now let us find magnitude of these forces. Force on 1 microcoulomb due to 2 microcoulomb at A. Let us denote it by FA. 9, 10 power 9 is the constant. Two charges are minus 6, 2, 10 power minus 6. By distance is 5 root 2 centimeter. 5 root 2 centi is 10 power minus 2 square. 18 by 5 newton or 3.6 newton. And what is the direction of 3.6? Because of repulsion along OC. Force on 1 microcoulomb due to minus 5 microcoulomb at B is, constant is 9, 10 power 9, two charges 10 power minus 6, 5, 10 power minus 6, divided by distance between them is 5 root 2, 10 power minus 2 square. Equal to 9 newton, and this 9 newton is along OB. Force on 1 microcoulomb due to 2 microcoulomb but C is 2 charges are 10 power minus 6, 2 10 power minus 6, distance is 5 root 2, 10 power minus 2, its square, 3.6 newton. force due to charge D constant 10 power minus 6, second charge is 5 10 power minus 6, distance it is 9 Newton, O D. Let us see the diagram once. Force on 1 microcoulomb due to 2 is away along OC. Force between these two is along OB. Force between these two charges is along OA. Force between these two charges is along OD. Let us find the resultant of these two and resultant of these. Let us find the resultant of these two forces. Since these two forces are in opposite directions, FA minus FC, which is 3.6 minus 3.6 equal to 0. It is BF dash. Now, resultant of these two forces. The resultant of these two forces. These two forces. Since these two are in opposite directions, it is the difference of the forces. This resultant is also zero. Therefore, the resultant force, on one microcoulomb at O is zero. An electrostatic field line is a continuous curve. That is, a field line cannot have sudden breaks. Why not? Electrostatic force is a long range force, that is the range is infinity. Electric field line is the line along which a test positive charge moves. If there is sudden break in electric field line, then at that broken region there is no electric field, which contradicts the above statement, means which contradicts that the electric force is long range force. Hence electric field line is continuous curve. If there is a charge, because of this charge, if a test charge experiences force, then this tends to move in this direction. If there is no electric field in this region, then this test charge experiences force at this point, it experiences force at this point, experiences force at this point, but it cannot experience force when it is in this broken region. But it cannot be so, because there is electric force at each and every point due to this charge. That is why this broken region is not allowed and electric field line is always a continuous line. Explain why two electric field lines never cross each other at any point. If these two are electric field lines, then a test positive charge at this point experiences force in this direction. A test positive charge at this point experiences force in this direction. But if a test positive charge is at the junction, then it cannot go in this and in this direction. It can have only one direction of motion. That is why we should not draw like this. So crossed fields are not allowed. Electric field line is the line along which a test positive charge moves. If two lines are crossed at P, then at P the test charge cannot move in two different directions. Hence, the electric field lines cannot cross each other. 8th question. Two point charges 3 micro and minus 3 micro are located 20 cm apart in vacuum. What is the electric field at the midpoint of the line AB joining the charges? Two charges. Two charges are separated by 0.2 meter. O is the midpoint of the line joining the charges. Therefore, AO is 0.1, OB is 0.1 meter. Let us write the formula first. Consider electric field equal to constant Q by R square 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Electric field at O due to 3 micro coulomb is E1 equal to 9 × 10⁹ is the constant. This charge is 3 × 10⁻⁶ divided by distance between this charge and O is 10 cm, that is 10⁻⁹ meter square equal to 2.7 × 10⁶ Newton per coulomb. Since this is positively charged, the direction of field is always away. So this is the direction of field due to this charge, E1. Next, electric field at O due to minus 3 micro coulomb is E2 equal to 9 × 10⁹. The second charge is 3, magnitude of the charge is 3 micro, distance is 0.1, again 10⁻⁹ square. Which is 2.7 × 10⁶ Newton per coulomb. And direction of this electric field, since this is negatively charged, the direction of electric field is again towards. So this is the second electric field, E2. This electric field is along OB. This electric field is also along OB. Therefore, the resultant field at O is sum of these two, because these two are in the same direction. 5.4 × 10⁶ Newton per coulomb. Direction is along OB. If a negative test charge of magnitude 1.5 × 10⁹ coulomb is placed at this point, what is the force experienced by the test charge? So, force on −1.5 × 10⁹ coulomb at O is F equal to charge into electric field equal to charge is −1.5 × 10⁹. Electric field is 5.4, 10 power 6. The direction of force is against the direction of electric field, or F is along OA. A system of two charges, 2.5 10 power minus 7 and minus 2.5 10 power minus 7 coulomb, located at points 00 minus 15 centimeter and 00 plus 15 centimeter respectively. What are the total charge and electric dipole moment of the system? If this is z-axis, x-axis and y-axis is perpendicular and outward, then coordinates of this is 0, 0, 15 centimeter. So at 0, 0, 15 centimeter, there is this second charge, minus 2.5, 10 power minus 7. At this point, 0, 0, minus 15 centimeter, there is the first charge, positive charge, plus 2.5, 10 power minus 7 coulomb. Since these two are equal and opposite charges, the total charge is 0. Plus of minus 2.5, 10 power minus 7. Equal to 0. Electric dipole moment of the system. Electric dipole moment denoted by P equal to Q into 2A. Magnitude of each charge is 2.5 10 power minus 7. Distance between these two charges, this is 15 centimeter plus 15 centimeter is 30 centimeter, 0.3, equal to 0.75 10 power minus 7 charge into distance coulomb meter. And the direction of dipole moment is always from negative charge to positive charge along the line joining the charges. So this is the direction of dipole moment, P cap, from minus Q to plus Q. Along the line joining the charges, an electric dipole with dipole moment 4 10 power minus 9 coulomb meter is aligned at 30 degree with the direction of uniform electric field of magnitude given. Calculate magnitude of torque acting on the dipole. This is a uniform electric field. Electric field intensity is 5 10 power 4 Newton per coulomb. The dipole makes an angle 30 degree with respect to the electric field. That is also given. Calculate magnitude of the torque. Torque tau equal to P cross E, where P is electric dipole moment, electric field intensity, equal to PE sine theta if magnitude of torque is taken, equal to dipole moment is 4 10 power minus 9, electric field intensity is 5 10 power 4 sine 30 degree. Sine 30 is half, this becomes 2. 10, so it is 10 power minus 4. Since it is torque, Newton meter. A polythene piece rubbed with wool is found to have a negative charge 3 10 power minus 7 coulomb. Estimate the number of electrons transferred. So it is based on quantization of charge. So Q equal to N into E, implies n equal to q by e. Charge is 3 × 10⁻¹ by charge of an electron is 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹. Therefore, n equal to 1.875 × 10⁻¹². Since it is found to have negative charge, electron should be added. Therefore, n equal to 1.875 × 10⁻¹² electrons are added. Electrons are added. Is there a transfer of mass from wool to polythene? Yes, since polythene acquires electrons, a polythene piece rubbed with wool is found to have negative charge. So polythene acquires negative charge means it acquires electrons. Each and every electron has mass. Therefore, is there a transfer of mass means? Answer, yes. Two insulated charged copper spheres A and B have their centers separated by distance 50 cm. What is the mutual force of electrostatic repulsion if the charge on each is 6.5 × 10⁻¹⁷ coulomb? The radii of A and B are negligible compared to the distance of separation. And force of 9 × 10⁻¹⁹, charges are 6.5 × 10⁻¹⁷, 6.5 × 10⁻¹⁷, divided by distance is 0.5 square, 1.52 × 10⁻², Newton. Repulsive in nature. What is the force of repulsion if each sphere is charged double the above amount and the distance between them is halved? F is proportional to q1 q2 by r square, and f dash is proportional to q1 dash q2 dash by r dash square. But q1 dash is 2 × q1, q2 dash is 2 × q2. This is given. Charges are doubled and distance is also doubled. Therefore, f dash by f equal to q1 dash q2 dash by r dash square q1 q2 by r square. Q1 dash is 2 q1, 2 q2, q2 dash is 2 q2, divided by 2 r square, q1 q2 by r square. q1 q2 r square get cancels. 2 square is 4, 2 to 4, so it is equal to 1. Therefore, f dash equal to 1.52 × 10⁻², Newton. 13th question. Suppose the spheres A and B in exercise 12th have identical sizes. A third sphere of same size but uncharged is brought in contact with the first, then brought in contact with the second, and finally removed from both. What is the new force of repulsion between A and B? This is A. This is B. When C is brought in contact, when A and C are touched and then separated, charge on C is, half of this charge is transferred to C. Therefore, charge on C is 6.5 plus 0, this is initial charge of C divided by 2. 6.5 10 power minus 7 charge of A, initially C is neutral, so half of this charge is transferred to C, 3.25 10 power minus 7 coulomb. Now C is brought in contact with B, touched and then separated. B and C are touched and then separated, then charge on C is average of these two, because now C has 3.25 10 power minus 7 coulomb. Therefore 6.5 10 power minus 7 plus 3.25 10 power minus 7 divided by 2 equal to 4.88 into 10 power minus 7 coulomb. And charges on A are 3.25 10 power minus 7 coulomb, because of 6.25 is transferred, and charge on C is 6.5 10 power minus 7 minus 1.63 10 power minus 7. This is charge lost by B to C. Therefore, charge on B is, this is B, charge on B is 4.87. 10 power minus 7 coulomb. Now the new force of repulsion between these two spheres is F double dash equal to 9 10 power 9. This is 3.25 10 power minus 7, 4.87 10 power minus 7 divided by distance is 0.5 square, equal to 0.57 into 10 power minus 2 Newton. F double dash, this is repulsive. Figure shows tracks of three charged particles in a uniform electrostatic field. Give the signs of three charges. Which particle has the highest charge to mass ratio? This charged particle is deflected towards positive, therefore this should be negatively charged. This is also deflected towards negative positive, therefore this should be negative. This charged particle is deflected towards negative plate, therefore this should be positive. Charge to mass ratio is charge to mass. Which particle has the highest charge to mass ratio? First particle, it is negatively charged, minus q by m is for first particle, minus q by m is for second particle, whereas for the third it is plus charge, plus q by m for the third. These are with negative values, this is with positive, therefore third particle has highest charge to mass ratio. Consider a uniform electric field E, 3 10 power 3 I cap Newton per coulomb. What is the flux of this field through a square of 10 cm on a side whose plane is parallel to yz plane? X-axis. This plane is parallel to yz plane. What is the flux of this field through a square? So electric flux is given by electric field dotted with area vector equal to Ea cos, for this surface. So angle between area vector and electric field, and electric field is along x axis. It is 3 × 10³ I cap. I cap is unit vector along x axis. Therefore it is cos 0 equal to electric field 3 × 10³, area vector 10 cm each, therefore 10⁻¹ square, it is a square, length into breadth, into cos 0 is 1. So it is 3. × 10⁻³, it is 30. Electric flux is electric field dotted with area vector, Newton meter square per coulomb. What is the flux through the same square if the normal to its plane makes a 60° angle with the x-axis? Normal to this plane, let this be area vector. Area vector makes an angle 60°. Okay. Electric field is 3 × 10³. Area is 10⁻¹ square. Cos theta, cos 60. Cos 60 is half. This gives 30 into half, it is 15 Newton meter square per coulomb. Electric flux is a scalar quantity. What is the net flux of a uniform electric field in exercise 1.15 through a cube of side 20 cm oriented so that its faces are parallel to the coordinate planes? Electric field is along x-axis, 3 × 10³ along x-axis. For this shaded portion, for this face, for this shaded face, electric field is along x-axis. Area vector is outward. Therefore, angle between these two is 180. Now, for this second shaded face, electric field is along x-axis. Area vector is also along x-axis. And angle between these two is 0°. Therefore, net electric flux phi equal to flux through first plus flux through second. Flux through first is E dotted with area plus E dotted with area. This is second, this is first. EA cos 180 plus EA cos 0. Cos 180 is minus. Minus EA plus EA equal to 0. Lines of forces entering this should leave this. Therefore, total flux is also equal to 0. Careful measurement of electric field at the surface of a black box indicates that the net outward flux through the surface of the box is 8 × 10³ Newton meter square per coulomb. What is the net charge inside the box? So net flux equal to 1 by epsilon naught times total charge enclosed, implies total charge equal to flux into epsilon naught equal to flux is 8 × 10³, epsilon naught is 8.85 × 10⁻¹² equal to 71 × 10⁻¹ coulomb. This is the charge. Since it is outward flux, charge should be positive. Okay. Next, if the net outward flux through the surface of a box is zero, could you conclude that there is no charges inside the box? Why or why not? If the box has equal and opposite charges, then flux due to positive charge is outward and flux due to negative charge is inward. We can't claim that there is no charge, but net charge equal to zero. So if flux equal to zero implies that net charge equal to zero. A point charge 10 microcoulomb is at a distance 5 cm directly above the center of the square. So length of each side is 10 cm, whereas this distance is 5 cm. If you carefully observe, length of each side is 10, but this height is 5. So we can construct a box. We can construct a box where this charge is at the exactly center. Therefore, flux through this face, shaded face, is nothing but flux through each face of this cube. Therefore, flux through the square is equal to 1/6 of q by epsilon naught. 1/6 of, because there are 6 faces, front back, total charge is q, 10 micro, 10 × 10⁻¹ q naught epsilon naught is 8.85 × 10⁻¹² equal to 1.88 × 10⁵ newton meter square per coulomb. A point charge 2 microcoulomb is at the center of a cubic Gaussian surface 9 cm on edge. What is the net electric flux through the surface? Charge is at the center. Therefore, flux through the Gaussian surface is total charge by epsilon naught. Here area doesn't matter, that is why this is of no use. Charge is 2 micro 10⁻¹ divided by epsilon naught is 8.85 × 10⁻¹² equal to 2.26 × 10⁵ newton meter square per coulomb. A point charge causes flux to pass through a Gaussian sphere of radius 10 cm. Let this be a Gaussian sphere of radius 10 cm. Okay. The charge is at the center, q. If the radius of the Gaussian surface were doubled, how much flux would pass through the surface? If radius is doubled, then new flux is also same. So new flux is also equal to −1.0 × 10³ newton meter square per coulomb. What is the value of point charge? B. Flux equal to charge by epsilon naught implies charge equal to epsilon naught times flux, 8.85 × 10⁻¹² into flux is 10³ minus 10 power 3 minus 8.85 10 power minus 9 coulomb. This is the charge at the center. A conducting sphere of radius 10 cm has an unknown charge. So this is a conducting sphere of radius 10 cm. Radius equal to 10 cm, which is 0.1 meter. If electric field 20 cm from the center of the sphere is 1.5. Now this is center. This is point P, which is at a distance 20 cm. So this is 0.2 meter. So if electric field intensity is 1.5 10 power 3 Newton per coulomb, what is the net charge on the sphere? Electric field is given by constant Q by R square. This is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Therefore, charge equal to electric field into R square by 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. 1.5 10 power 3 distance. Distance from the center is 0.2. 0.2 square divided by 9 10 power 9 equal to 6.67 10 power minus 9 coulomb. This is charge. A uniformly charged conducting sphere of 2.4 meter diameter has a surface charge density given. So surface charge density is 80 10 power minus 6 coulomb per meter square, and diameter D equal to 2.4 meter implies that radius equal to diameter by 2, 2.4 by 2 equal to 1.2 meter. This is radius of the sphere. Find the charge on the sphere of radius 1.2 meter. Surface charge density is given. Consider sigma equal to charge by area. Therefore, charge equal to sigma into area. Sigma into surface area of sphere is 4 pi r square. Sigma is 80 10 power minus 6 4 3.14. radius is 1.2 square. 1.44 10 power minus 3 coulomb. This is the charge. What is the total electric flux leaving the surface of the sphere? Flux equal to charge by epsilon naught. Charge is 1.44 10 power minus 3 divided by 8.85 10 power minus 12 equal to 1.67 10 power 8. Since it is flux, Newton meter square per coulomb. An infinite line charge produces a field of at a distance of 2 cm. Calculate the linear charge density. This is a linear charge. Let it be plus, positively charged. If this is a point P, which is at a distance of 2 cm from the conductor, R equal to 2 cm from the conductor, calculate linear charge density. So electric field is given. Electric field is 9 10 power 4 Newton per coulomb. Okay, and electric field due to straight conductor, charged straight conductor, is given by constant 2 lambda by R. This constant is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. 9 10 power 9 2 lambda wanted. Distance is 2 centi minus 2 square. Electric field is 9 × 10⁴. Cancel this 9. Simplify. Lambda equal to 10⁻⁷ coulomb per meter. Charge by length. Two large thin metal plates are parallel and close to each other. On their inner faces, the plates have surface charge densities of opposite signs and of magnitude 17 × 10⁻²⁰ coulomb per meter square. What is the electric field? In the outer region of first plate, in the outer region of second plate, between plates. These two are the plates, A and B. Plates have surface charge densities of opposite signs. Let this be minus sigma, this is plus sigma, means there is positive charge on B, there is negative charge on A. In the outer region of first plate, here at P, consider electric field equal to sigma by 2 ε₀. At P, electric field equal to, see, because of negative charge, electric field is towards, because of positive, electric field is away. These two electric fields are equal and opposite. This is due to negative, this is due to positive. So electric field due to negative plus electric field due to positive. This electric field is sigma by 2 ε₀ minus sigma by 2 ε₀ equal to 0, because these two are in opposite directions. Let me draw vector sign. Let this be a point. Because of negative, electric field inwards. Because of positive, electric field is away. Therefore, this is due to positive charge, this is due to negative charge. At Q, net electric field is E due to negative plus E due to positive, which is sigma by 2 ε₀ plus sigma by 2 ε₀ equal to sigma by, sigma is 17 × 10⁻²² by 8.85 × 10⁻¹². 1.92 × 10⁻¹⁰. Electric field, Newton per Coulomb. Electric field on the other side, at this point, because of positive, away, because of negative, towards, this is point R, this is due to negative, this is due to positive, again, at R, resultant electric field equal to E due to minus plus E due to plus equal to sigma by 2 ε₀ because of negative minus plus sigma by 2 ε₀. Resultant field is 0.